I grabbed the wand, stirred up the solution a little bit, and I don't know if this is going to work, but it's a good try. Huh? Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Oh! Oh, I'm pretty sure this is the first time this has happened at the feet of the cross of new life.
Those with an intact census Catholicus, which does not include anti-Pope Francis, are instinctually repelled by such circuses. Just imagine being so denuded of reverence, so denuded of self-respect, so denuded simply of taste. Just imagine having such an ignoble soul to the point that you actually continue to sit there while that circus begins and proceeds. Just imagine the flatness of soul it takes to continue to sit there. Really, to enter that building at all, because surely it wasn't the first time for most of those people there. And anyone with an intact census Catholicus, if that was their first time there, will never return. What you've just seen is of the Novus Ordo anti-church. It is anti-Catholic, and those with an intact census Catholicus immediately smelled the smoke of hell coming through the screen upon seeing what they just saw. And they heard the laughter of Satan in the laughter of that vile man with his bubbles. Just imagine the contempt those circus ringleaders had for that crowd. Imagine the cynicism of those ringleaders. Imagine the low opinion they hold of that crowd, those buffoons attending that circus. And clapping, and laughing, and dancing. Oh, both the leaders and the followers are two cheeks of the same Novus Ordo ass. And the sheer useful idiocy of those people in that crowd clapping and dancing like seals and fools. And the Novus Ordo circus ringleaders full of contempt for that crowd, much of it justified, given their useful idiocy. Imagine what they must have been thinking. I'm actually getting away with this. They're actually applauding me. They're going along with it. Again! Oh, the contempt, the burning contempt the leaders of the Novus Ordo anti-church have for the people and the sheer foolishness of the people. You see, it's very common among traditionalists to blame the leaders of the Novus Ordo anti-church. But the people themselves are also responsible for going along with it. Certainly by this point they're responsible. It may have been somewhat excusable immediately after the Judas Council, but now, no longer. Now, those of the so-called conservative Novus Ordo faction, as if it were objectively possible to be both conservative and yoked with the Novus Ordo anti-church, will say that this is a liturgical abuse. This is a lie. For the Novus Ordo anti-mass, even when committed entirely according to its rubrics, is an inherently irreverent service, an intentionally Protestantized and therefore anti-Catholic service. This, which you have just seen, and many other spectacles like it, they are the logical results of the Judas Council. They occur not in spite of Vatican II, but because of Vatican II. The time bombs of the Judas Council allow for this, and even encourage such creativity. No, don't let anyone tell you that this is in spite of Vatican II. No, it's because of Vatican II. And it's no accident that the likes of Francis and all the rest of them before him of the Novus Ordo anti-church, it's no accident that they have allowed these spectacles to continue for the last 50 years while simultaneously ruthlessly attacking those known as traditionalists. In other words, ruthlessly attacking actual Catholics. Age, thou art shamed. Oh, shame, where is thy blush?